crystal core cannon!
Louise's Trustmaster reward is the Kodum-Dum Blaster. It's a fire magic gun that's so complicated to use that it can only be wielded by Louise. Her Super Trustmaster reward is the Kodum-Dum Suit. Unlike the blaster, anyone can use it, but in this case, it's as intended by the scientists, so at least that's justified. It's the best magic heavy armor in the game, with an additional 50% fire resistance buff attached to it. Onto her active abilities. Louise's abilities are physical attacks that deal magic damage and Chain of Chaos Wave Awaken. Firestarter imbues her with fire for 3 turns, imbues her team with fire for 1 turn, and enables an area effect that boosts fire damage by very helpful game. Ironic Fire Blaster is weak. Really weak. Even if it partially ignores Spirit, what is this modifier? But it also does morale-based damage on top of it, and while it certainly boosts its strength, you have to wonder how it works in other battles. At least it fills your team's limit burst gauge by a decent amount with each use style. Then she has several modified gear abilities. Despite their shared names, they all do very different things. Heavy firepower inflicts a 130% fire impero and raises your team's fire damage by 20%. For the next 2 turns, it will raise Louise's fire damage by 30%. Diverse Arsenal grants your team a 50% physical killer buff against all species. For the next 2 turns, it grants Louise a 100% physical killer buff against all species. Tactical Armor grants your team a 40% general mitigation buff and a 20% physical and magical mitigation buff. For the next 2 turns, Louise will get a 40% physical and magical mitigation buff. Power Boost wipes any breaks on your team, grants them resistance to breaks, and gives them a 250% full stat buff. For the next 2 turns, it'll automatically wipe any debuffs on Louise, and grants her a 300% full stat buff. Fire Foam can be used once per battle. It lets your team absorb fire damage. Incapacitate Target can be used once per battle. It inflicts a 135% fire impero, lowers the enemy's accuracy by 50%, and lowers your spirit by 90%, matching Savior of Souls Lightning. Passives. Ho, she is stacked. She has a quadruple cast in this form, which can be used with every active ability. But for Trustmaster reward or Super Trustmaster reward equipped, she gains a Guts buff, automatically fills her morale gauge, activates a HP barrier, and gives her a 100% killer boost against all species. And just look at these passive stats! Chain Cap boost when dual wielding, complete boost to equipment magic when dual wielding, another 100% physical killer against all species, 50% boost to both physical and magical evasion, resistance to stop and charm, and HP recovery when dealing damage. But now we have to ruin everything. On to her limit burst. Crystal Core Cannon. Oh, that's what she's saying. I thought it was 4 for Schwartz or something else when I heard it. Regardless, it's pretty disappointing. Not only does it completely betray your expectations of the sound of a baby cat, but the modifier isn't all that impressive either. It deals fire magic damage, lets Louise absorb fire attacks for a turn, and increases her limit burst damage by 150% for the next 5 turns. Well, time to change forms. Louise has a true brave shift, which has no limitations whatsoever. Active abilities. She has different types of ironic blasters. They're all physical attacks that deal magic damage, and have similar damage functions as the initial one I previously covered. Shielding grants her a HP barrier and Chains of Bolting Strike. Disarming lowers the enemy's gun resistance by 35%, and Chains of Chaos Wave Awaken. Repairing gives Louise a HP and MP regen buff. Neutralizing inflicts a 80% full break, and Chains of Chaos Wave Awaken. Nanomachine Overload can be used 4 times per battle. It deals relatively large morale-based damage, fills her limit burst gauge, and boosts its damage by 200%. But before we look at that, passives. But for Trustmaster reward or Super Trustmaster reward equipped, she now deals more damage to enemies who've had their break gauges broken, and her normal attack will chain with Stardust Ray. However, she loses the morale gauge fill and HP barrier in exchange. Other than that, her passives remain the same. So, that leads us to her limit burst. It raises her accuracy and deals magic damage that gets stronger with each use. Maybe the voice acting was so weak because it reflected the damage modifier. It also increases the damage modifier of Nanomachine Overload. Let's prioritize Brave abilities. I recommend raising all of them. Incapacitate Target drives up the Fire Impero, Accuracy Debuff, and Spirit Break. Disarming Ironic Blaster raises the Gun Impero, and Nanomachine Overload raises her buffs. Time to make a damage rotation. On turn 1, cast Fire Starter, Modified Gear, Heavy Firepower, Modified Gear, Diverse Arsenal, and Modified Gear, Power Boost. On turn 2, switch forms. Triple cast Disarming Ionic Blaster, and top it off with Nanomachine Overload. Of course, if brakes apply, feel free to start with neutralizing ionic blaster. On turn 3, blast away with our limit burst. From here, you'll repeat the rotation again. I advise you to hold off on using incapacitate target until her brave shift's limit burst is at full power. Then you can start the rotation with it and use Firestarter on the turn after that. So how good is Louise? Her passives are incredibly stacked and her kit is well-rounded to boot. Though a great deal of it relates to morale, she has a lot of abilities that can be used outside of it as well. Her fire damage and support is solid, though not exactly dedicated. She's a great fire damage dealer, but the magnitude and duration of her support buffs aren't as grand as I'd like, especially without the morale-based boost. Despite that, she's still one of our stronger magic damage dealers, with the capability to soar even higher with those killer buffs. She gets even better in Clash of Wills, preemptively raising the morale gauge and receiving further damage buffs. Admittedly, outside of it, her best call to fame is just her damage output. While her support buffs cover a wide range, the team buffs, especially the killers, aren't significant enough to justify her over a dedicated support unit. It's funny, despite being a support, the majority of the buffs are basically skewed towards her own benefit. Still, for what it's worth, Louise is an excellent unit, but her voice acting sucks, so I guess she gets a 0 out of 10. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, leave a like and subscribe. Comment below if you get Louise. As much as I like her design and limit burst animation, I also feel sad inside when I hear the voice. Sounds like it's been recorded in the bathroom.